Hello, teachers. My name is Cade. I'm going to be one of your instructors for this course, and I'm really excited to be able to spend some time with you. I hope that you enjoy taking this course and that you find it helpful as you're learning to be an even better teacher than you already are. And just the fact that you're taking a course like this is a great indicator that you are a good teacher and that you have the desires and the capacity to become a better one. As teachers, we want to provide the best experiences for our students. We want them to learn efficiently, and we want them to be very well prepared for their futures. One of the challenges of teaching is that all of our students have such different needs. They're different from each other. They have different backgrounds, different experiences, different strengths, different weaknesses. And so being able to teach well requires us to be able to customize our teaching, our instruction, to each of the students in our class. Digital tools, computers and phones, and the tools that we can use on those devices give us more time, more power, more opportunity to learn about our students, to understand them, and to customize or to adapt our instruction for each of those students. And that's what we're going to learn how to do in this course, is how to use digital tools and some non-digital tools to understand our students better, and then to use that understanding to make changes in our classroom for individual students that help them to learn in the very best possible way. This course is going to be divided into a couple of different sections. We're going to look at a couple of specific tools used to collect data to understand our students and to make those adaptations in our classroom. The tools that we'll cover are assignments and quizzes, attendance records, class observations, conferences, and surveys. As we go through each of those tools, we'll learn how to use that tool to first collect data, second, to interpret data, third, to use that data to understand our students and to make adaptations, and then fourth, to share that data with our students and with their parents and other instructors, so that all of us can make important decisions that will benefit the student.